Hello, hello, hello! What is going on? Hey guys. Hi. Hope everyone had a good Wednesday so far. Mine was alright. Just people being annoying, school draining, but we're not here to talk about school. We're here to have fun with Chloe and Rachel. And see how this develops. We have two more episodes left, but technically this is the last one in the Chloe and Rachel, I think. I'm pretty sure, because this is a prequel. Like, this whole thing is a prequel, but this is like when they're young. And that is just Max and Chloe. So we have just this left. I didn't really do much of an intro, because I don't really do intros for these types of videos. Life is Strange, the first game and this game, I definitely edit very differently because I like to keep in the story bits and kind of edit out the parts where I'm looking around. Some people might not like that, some people might like that. That's just how I edit these types of story-based games. And I like it. It makes it feel like you're watching a movie. I leave in the parts I think are prevalent to, or the parts that I like. And I think it's okay to be a little selfish like that. But I think we should get into it and start the episode. Last one. We learn that the lady they saw kissing into. Well, they're gonna tell us. They're gonna recap. Don't worry. They're gonna tell us. I'm more like wondering how.
Previously,
I'll say it after.
On Life is Strange before the storm.
I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel.
No fucking chance.
I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Yes. Let's leave. For real, if you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Rip. Ooh. Like, right back into it. Sorry.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah, your birth mother.
Damn.
I'm gonna tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Chloe,
right here. Good. I need you.
That's what I thought. I was like, she wanted me to be here with her. I wasn't just gonna, like, not. Also, I'm nosy! That's not the real reason.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long. She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape. Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there.
I suspected.
For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. I was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. Someone who could never be satisfied with anyone or anything, even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
Damn.
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true, we kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her, that she felt like she'd gotten her life together, finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done, but after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother. she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again and again to keep you safe.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
Rachel.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
That is right. Who says it's his decision? Because isn't she, like, an adult? I don't know.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. Like, people change, right?
Maybe so.
Mm-hmm.
But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Ooh, you didn't have to, you didn't have to say that.
I think I need to lie down.
I'm worried for her right at this moment. That's a lot to process. Oh my god, I couldn't imagine. I've never been in such a situation before. Wow. That's almost more rough than finding out your dad cheated on your mom. Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? That was a party. No.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Yeah, we're gonna go see her. I wanna actually talk to her real fast.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
Yeah, I have a little more sympathy for him.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
I agree with this shouldn't be up to Rachel. It's... Yes, he's trying to do the right thing in his own mind, but Rachel is also old enough to decide if that's something she wants to do. Even if it is, like, gonna be a mistake to go see her mom, it's also, like, it is up to her. Like, she should have a say in it.
But shouldn't that be up to Rachel to decide?
Rachel is curious.
Mm-hmm.
And determined. She's always going to want to know more.
I can believe that.
She won't be concerned about her own safety. She never has been.
I see where they're both coming from.
Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates.
Uh-oh.
But please, put my daughter's safety first.
Oh, God. I will try the truth. Oh, I don't know how I feel! Sorry.
That
is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss. Protect her from that. Please.
I'll say it to him,
I'll do what I can.
I'm not gonna have to choose,
I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
I hope tonight hasn't messed up Rachel's memories of family trips like this.
Me too. It might for a hot minute, though. She smashed.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table.
She smashed the shit out of it. Completely. Hey.
Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
Okay, Rose. Sorry that tonight turned out so differently.
That's all right. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Thanks. But why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, it's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
I guess I'm not great. Rachel and I were really happy a few hours ago, and now...
Maybe you can see why James wanted to keep this a secret. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
Sarah shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
I don't know, I'm so divided.
I'm so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
Yeah.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband.
It's a nice answer.
His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
That's a good answer, because she, instead of just saying yes, she was like, I never met her. I better not be the deciding factor if she goes to see her mom or not. Because I honestly don't know the right answer. I wouldn't know. It's a rough situation. Oh, she has glow-in-the-dark stars.
I need need some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her.
Be there for Rachel.
Hey, Rachel. I'm glad you're here, Chloe. Of course.
Oh shit, that's it.
Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected. Even you, Willy, couldn't come up with the tragedy Rachel's going through. Maybe I can make the world a less scary place. On stage, I think Rachel said,
American Graffiti, I got an achievement. Cute. Okay, Portrait of Survivors, Daily Dick Pics! Sorry. Greasy Gunk, Torture. Life on. Okay.
I've heard that Rachel and Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe.
Oh, yikes. Don't think about it. Flowers. Oh.
At least she'll have something from tonight. Hard to believe the show was only a few hours ago. Seems like everything has changed since then.
Yeah. Graffiti.
I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one?
Herbology. Weed!
That's the one.
What else can we look at? There's an emergency kit in the room.
Rachel might not survive her family, but at least she'll survive the zombie apocalypse.
That's true. I can take the flashlight. Don't mind if I do. Like, I'm just walking around the... Oh. That's rough.
Is there a section on how to walk fours through batshit crazy family drama? No?
Oh, this is her, personality type. She's a reformer, a helper, and an individualist. Yeah, she is.
The yin and badass yang of Rachel Amber.
For else the end.
We were so close to making our break last night. Now, I don't know. Rachel has so many inspirations, she can barely keep them all contained.
So upon time, Kiss Me Kate, Bunnies, Casting Call, Road Trip. She loves space.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool.
True.
Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so alone. This light needs more light.
I got a flashlight.
Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that. Makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on.
Let's go. I was supposed to pick that up. Rachel's just hearing us messing around in her room.
All ready for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first. Hey.
No.
Hey, check it out.
No,
it's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. Why?
They remind us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see.
Sometimes we see it.
But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point?
Yeah.
It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman. My real mom. She's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination.
Period.
Good.
I don't think she wants to, like, hear me debate her. It's queer. Sorry.
I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone. The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me, I think I need to see her.
No, no.
Is that wrong?
I don't know.
Honestly, I have no idea what's right or wrong in this situation. I just know that whatever you decide, I'm in.
I'm okay with that answer.
But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
I know the dad is like really, and I'm kind of not
for her
scene.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her.
If she wants to know, why shouldn't stop her?
I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
I think I can handle that.
I think I might be able to fix up that truck in the junkyard.
Really?
I'll give it my best.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams, he's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.
I don't know. I think either way, I don't feel like, I didn't feel like telling her no. Because it is her, like, her choice to go see her mom or not. Because it's her mom, not mine. Even though the dad told me not to. I'm doing my best here. It's hard, these decisions. These decisions are hard.
Dad, I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
Don't you mean my memories? I don't think you remember after you're dead.
Touché. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
I like the noise it made.
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
No.
Like what? There's nothing here.
Really? That's odd. Well, I know it's not the spark plug. I just got that replaced.
What?
I said it's not the spark plug!
Huh.
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about the whole world being a stage, so might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
Thank you.
I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself.
Bruh.
Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Bruh.
Dad.
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me.
This is rough. She dreams about this.
It's going to be okay.
Damn. Dude, Chloe's not okay. Oh, come on, man. Fuck you, Victoria. No one asked. No one cares about you, Victoria. No way.
Wait. What the shit? Has someone been going through my room?
Wow.
Doesn't seem like Mom. She wouldn't leave a mess like this. Wait. David? That motherfucker. Whatever. I don't have time for this shit. I've gotta help Rachel. Okay. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. Plus, he likes me, and he owes me one from yesterday. I can do this.
We can do this. We got this. We're a unit.
Come on, dude. Pick up.
So why did we have to go back there?
I got your collector's fee. Coming to get it?
Hey, Frank. I was actually gonna cash in for a favor instead. What do you say?
Never run out of crap, do you?
I need to find that woman who was in your RV yesterday. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I would really appreciate it. I'm your favorite client, remember?
Let's go.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real.
How are you back in our room then?
That went well.
You change?
I guess.
I like this outfit.
What am I getting myself into?
You can find a beanie though. I saw some people playing this game and she was wearing a beanie and I was like, fuck, I missed out on a beanie? Now I gotta. Guess chicken butt. Sorry. Oh, it's for the truck.
Okay, I've got 2 hours to... Huh? Mom usually does my laundry when she gets sick of me not doing my laundry. Maybe she believed me for once about never coming back home.
Well, I can't get changed.
Still can't fucking believe that David went through my stuff.
That is really... Oh, look at us with the fly. That is stupid. I hate parents. I don't hate. I very much dislike parents who are like that.
I'm about to rack up a lot more absences. Inaccurate as of yesterday. Someone should update this photo. So much has changed. I wonder if you'd even recognize me now.
No. You do look so much different.
Wonder what I can find out about Rachel's mom. Figures.
She got the Fisher Award. Fisher.
What? Nice to see my work is appreciated.
Yeah, what is this? I'm looking that up. Everyone shut up. KJ3XK9 question mark and then equals latest comment. No, not real. Damn it. Mad respect. No one asked you, Trevor. No one asked you. Burn. That's so classy.
A further layer of nuance. Nathan almost pissed himself.
What did they say about? Worthy special mention. This person getting active. Yeah.
Thou art an idiot. Whoa. Skips in a band?
Dude. Imagine wanting to suck someone's cock so much that you'd, like, do that shit.
Better than nothing.
There you go. Yay! Did something.
Sorry, board. I've got a real ride to fix up now. If Rachel and I were still leaving today, there's literally nothing in there that's worth taking.
Anything else I can look at? Not really. Okay, what?
I wonder if that's the universe where Dad's alive and Rachel has 3 happy parents. Dad's favorite jacket. Definitely taking that if Rachel and I ever leave.
Hell yeah.
Is Mom playing music?
This is just the beginning, bitch. So I was right all along. Rachel Amber is a fucking evil bitch. Yeah, she totally is. I guess you're thinking you're her little sidekick now. Yup. I've had it with the school. Nobody gave a shit about me last. Stop! But last night it was all Rachel. I don't know why I'm telling you this. Cause you're alone and regret being a bitch to me. That's not true. How dare you? Well, you're so fun.
Is that
David's towel? Where the hell is mine?
Yikes.
Okay. My towel. Score.
Oh.
I can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it.
Take it.
Ready for the best shower of my life.
Can I close the door?
Hot water. Don't.
Sorry.
Gross.
What?
I truly hate seeing so much of David's shit around here.
No, we're just not gonna say that we're home. Are we gonna leave the door open? I hope not. Avert your eyes! Ah, no one look! Give Chloe the space they need. No one. Everyone respect the boundary. It's not gonna show anything. But you know. Pirate towel. I'm not used to seeing a mirror not above the bathroom sink. Hey! Look at us! A little glimpse.
What do I feel like wearing on this easy ass day?
I got you. Oh, how what cute. Dragon, bonus close. Skull, I like the skull. Well, we'll see how it looks. Cause she puts on like a whole fit. Oh, it makes this look like Rachel Amber. I'll see how the dragon looks real fast before I stick to it. But twinning with Rachel Amber would be cute. Kinda like that. We'll see for bonus outfits. I also want a beanie! Nah, we're gonna twin. I think that's cute. Yeah, let's go.
Alright, one last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs.
You sure I can't wear a beanie? I thought there was like a thing. That's okay. This is gonna be interesting.
What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
True. Don't know if you can. And I'm pretty sure David's home.
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break.
Oh, Chloe,
at home.
It probably feels like
you are one class
really missed right
David
now,
Madsen.
Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Nice. Well done. Well done, guys.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did, but this is something different.
And that shirt, oh, I haven't seen it in ages.
Smother much?
Mom, smother me much?
Right. Sorry. None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe. Coming home was a smart decision.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh. Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I'm telling David about the play and
I shouldn't be hard on
it.
The mom that much. Even if I don't
really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you.
Whoa. Man's whipped through my room. Is it gonna be good? Cause
Mom.
Yikes.
I don't think this is the best idea.
You already promised.
Uh-oh.
Chloe, I've made an agreement with your mother to trust you. From now on.
You went to my room.
Really? What does that mean?
It means that from today forward,
okay,
I'm going to take you at your word. So
okay.
If you say you haven't been smoking or drinking, then I'll just leave you be.
Alright. Trust.
The idea is you should feel comfortable here, Chloe. David's not going to question you, and neither am I.
Oh, okay. I do want to know.
David's lying to your face, Mom. He searched my room.
You gave up any right to privacy.
Oh, okay.
I asked David to help me yesterday, and he only did what he thought was best.
You knew that David went through all of my...
That was before I talked to him and explained why I disagreed with that method.
I want to know if it happened before or if she knows.
To trust you in the first place.
I'm done with this.
Chloe, stop. I know why you're acting this way. And I know you're gonna regret it. Come here. Take a look at this.
It's a picture.
This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used
to true.
Joke about all the trouble we were going
to
get into.
Welcome back, Lego. Nice to see you.
Once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day.
Got something to say. What does that have to do with you going through our shit?
I've had my share of grief.
And?
I know what you're going through.
Grief's different for everyone. Excuse you.
I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here.
Uh-huh.
To do whatever I can.
Better answer.
To help you get
See, that's better,
over
David. That's a better answer.
The loss of your dad.
That's a better answer. Thank you. I appreciate it. Don't go through my shit. I like what you said, where you're like, I'm going to trust
Please.
What you say, because you
I'm
should trust
begging
me more.
You. Give David a chance, won't you?
Yes.
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
I'll give him a chance. He did look through my shit, but I was just explained to that it happened after. And he seems like he wants, even though he could clearly is like, I want to look through your shit. He clearly is trying. And this is a big deal. And it's also a big deal that he is saying that he's going to trust my word. Because I think that's what Rachel struggles with. How can you not give him a chance with that? It's so true. Do you see that haircut that can balance a bowl perfectly in the middle of his head? I am. It's just like, I was talking about how in the first few episodes it sounded like they just didn't trust Chloe at all. They didn't like ask for her side. They didn't ask for shit. So this is a big turnaround. I'm gonna accept it. That's a big deal. I appreciate that. He's not perfect.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy.
Still got the same cut.
They look close.
Glad to see the bowl cut is still, not the bowl cut, but the straight cut is still there.
Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Yeah, see, that was a change from...
Be careful out there, Chloe.
Okay. All right.
I love you.
You've redeemed
sweetheart.
Yourself for me, Lily.
All right.
He does. He looked exactly the same. Especially since it was blurry. Same cut, same stash. It looked like it was taken a week ago. So true.
What the hell?
Rice cereals. Oh, yeah.
Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck.
Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. If David is trying to give me a lot of trust, I will trust him back. It's just, last episode, holy shit. The way that David spoke to me, I was like, wow. The audacity! But I'm also one of those people that is not afraid to be mean to an adult or to be disrespectful back to someone. Just because you're older than me doesn't mean I'm gonna let you stomp all over my fucking shit. If you're being disrespectful to me, I'm not gonna respect you just because I'm younger. Stupid rule. Who came up with that rule? An adult. Yeah, you have to fix the trip.
Come on.
We got this.
Work with me here.
Did that work? Sorry, my leg is a little asleep. I love that.
Damn it!
Ow.
Better, but still needs a bit more love.
All right,
I can salvage.
Chloe, this is David. Sort of. Kind of project. We have a trusting me. No, no, I was just asking. Glad to see you talking interest. Keep it up. See, it's that's better.
I just need to find the right tool. It's not like I need a manual. But I'm really glad it's here.
Got it. First check and everything.
The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap.
Then let's go. Then we'll scrape the gunk off. Screwdriver. I don't know shit about cars. Well, actually, I know how to jump start a car and put air in the tire and gas in it. That's all one needs
that
to know.
Help keep shit distributed.
Oh.
Well, fuck. Go back from whence you came.
Period. Who texted me? Hey, Elliot. Oh, it's this dude again. Friend-zoned this man hard. Don't regret it. Kinda do, but don't.
This thing seems pretty gunked up.
I think I need the pliers for that.
I think I should move on to something else.
Oh, okay. My bad.
This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it.
Pliers! Elliot is giving off stalker vibes pretty bad. Or, like, I always think it's weird when, like, people, like, want
to see some problems.
Ask for hugs. They're like, oh, where's my hug? You know that one creepy uncle that's like, oh, where's my hug? And it's just like, bro. No.
There. Fits like a deadly electric glove.
I think people don't realize that people can say no to hugs. I don't need to hug you.
It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it?
Yeah, I'm glad I friend-zoned his ass. He needed it. He needed the reality check in his face. Where's my hug? Yeah, see? Or like the people that just like really want a hug.
Much better.
Like sometimes I'll just meet someone and I like hugs, but I just recently started like making sure I get consent for them. I definitely didn't when I was littler. I've changed. I'm working on it. But I love hugs, but I also don't hug strangers. So I always thought it was weird that when people like just met me, they're like, oh my god, can I have a hug? Like, it depends on the person. If they don't give me like
this
weird vibes,
gunked the fuck up.
Then I'm fine with it. But if like they're kind of creepy, then I'm just like, no. No, thank you. And they'll be like, whoa. And it's like, well, I'm allowed to say no. I don't know where it came from where people are like, oh shit.
Sick.
Why is it so weird that people are like, oh, I can't give you a hug? Why? It's like, because I said no. Like, calm down. Not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world, it's a hug. Sorry. For some reason that got benign.
Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits.
If a person wants to hug you, it will happen. There's usually no need to ask for it like some creep. True. Sometimes there's just like situations where it feels right. I am one of those people who does think asking for consent is good. But you're also right. Sometimes there are just situations. But again, I also think asking for consent is better. Because you never know. It's kind of like how, like, some people might struggle with it more than some of the people.
I need you.
Let's go!
Yeah.
Okay, well, don't crash it. We just fixed it. Don't crash it. Don't crash it. Let's go. I can change if I want to again. Beanie time.
Hey, Junkyard Queen, where are you at?
Oh, wait, she's wearing the other outfit that I could have worn.
Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so...
badass.
I was gonna say hot. But, yeah. Badass, too.
Cute.
Hey. Not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
You're practically a certified mechanic now. Even have the shirt to prove it.
Hell yeah. Let's go.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah.
Oh.
Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
Oh.
What's he doing here?
Hey, I thought we were cool after that Drew North thing. Don't you want to be cool?
Okay, well, I didn't know you would be here. I don't know what to say. That's all right. I'm okay with that answer. Or that just.
Gotta say, I really dig the whole tough girl thing.
Bruh.
Frank was right about you. How'd you like to work full time for us?
No.
Don't fucking touch her.
Period. No one ever. What was that? Why? What? Why are you here?
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly it's a whole other thing.
Okay, well, you touched me first, and she was just defending me.
Frank,
so I think you mean, why can't I get away with it?
That true?
What?
Yeah.
I don't know what he said.
It's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Huh. Maybe I'll show you.
What did he say?
See,
I wasn't paying attention.
You two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business.
Yeah.
I didn't go to a fancy academy. But that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you.
What is going on here?
He's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Yeah, why are you here?
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now.
why you give a shit about this woman.
Why do you care so much?
Why do you care so much?
Because fuck you.
Why is he here, Frank? You're just
Look,
not gonna do anything?
None of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
Me? What?
No. Tell me where she is now,
Rachel.
Wait a minute.
What? I don't understand the problem.
No way.
What the fuck is your problem?
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon,
your dad's a real piece of shit, you know.
So? We don't have anything to do with him.
Right.
Oh, you think that... What, you think he sent us to bust you?
Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not.
Brother, where did this come from?
This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
Yeah, what the fuck? I'm not upset that she did that.
Fucking bitch!
Uh-oh. Holy shit, holy shit, holy shit!
Rachel!
Damon! What the fuck? Chloe! Go! Now!
What the fuck?
Hold on. Shit. Shit. Shit.
Bro, what? Talk about anger issues. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's really bad. Did he stab her arm or her side? Because that makes this a lot different. I think he got the arm. We gotta go. Oh my god. Why did he care? What the fuck? Why did Frank allow him to be there? That was no one's fault. But Frank shouldn't have, like... Why did he bring him along? Frank, what was that? That was no one's fault. I don't think Frank thought that someone was gonna get stabbed. What the fuck? Is she gonna get stabbed either way? Did I have a say in this?
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's had a surgery, and now she's resting.
Thank God.
Chloe, what happened?
It is my fault.
It's my fault. I should have listened to you.
Sarah's mixed up somehow with this psycho Damon Merrick.
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah?
Yeah.
I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I
I didn't listen to what you said because she wanted to see. I didn't know she was going to get stabbed.
I got my dealer to meet us since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
To scare us away.
I think he wanted to scare us so he'd stop asking questions about his business.
Is that how it became violent?
Rachel did not get angry. He wanted dirt on you.
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
I said Rachel, but I didn't know he would. I think
I called her Rachel, and he figured it out from there.
It's not your fault. What happened next?
God, he's like
Damon had a knife out, and we all could see it. Then he said something that pissed Rachel off.
So she took.
She just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something. But when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
You got it.
What if Rachel still wants to meet Sarah?
After all this, I'm hoping she'll finally see reason.
No.
I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have
lived. It was that bad.
Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world.
She was definitely stabbed in the side, but not in the arm.
Sometime before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
What was the point in lying to him? why would I lie to him right there? His daughter got stabbed. What good would I do by lying? You know? Poor fucking Rachel.
Hey.
Poor Chloe.
Steph. How's Mikey?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Definitely.
Hang out with the D&D group. Let's go. I'm trying to like... Oh, is that Mikey's dad?
I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up. Sean Prescott. What's he writing to the hospital about?
God knows what. Man controls everything. Wait, I can read?
Is this for real?
Wait, what? One of our current patients is Michael North, a student at Blackwell Academy who was injured on school grounds. On physical safety of its students is core responsibility of any school. Blackwell has failed Mr. North in its assistance. I would therefore like to personally, and I stress anonymously, cover his medical expenses. If I may be assisting suspending the process. Oh, okay. That's nice. I guess.
Alright then.
This is Dad.
Thank you.
Or their dad.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
You
here to see Mikey?
Yeah.
How are things?
How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. Mikey's hurt, of course. But the doctors are saying it should heal up relatively quick.
Yay.
And Drew? Hey, maybe you heard. He's all set to go to Oregon State. Full ride for 4 years.
Full ride? That's really good.
That's awesome.
Holy shit. Full ride?
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now.
Aw.
I have a question maybe you can answer.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well, guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
You should probably ask Drew. I don't really know any details.
It's also not my place to say.
I do know that whatever it is, they did it because they wanted to help you.
Thanks, Chloe. I know they've been trying to help me out, money-wise. We're a family, you know? We deal with things together. Oh, excuse me.
Oh, I thought I can graffiti it. That would have been cool. Hey! I like that bear. That's a cute bear. Hey, hey!
Chloe!
Hey, you made it!
Hey, Chloe.
Hey. How's the arm, Mikey?
I wish it was the other one, so I could draw and stuff. But other than that, it's just broken.
Sweet hair, by the way.
I bet you could pull off Sailor Mercury.
thanks.
Any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
Why? What happened?
Rachel was stabbed in the arm.
No, it wasn't the arm.
By Damon fucking Merrick.
Yeah, that's not funny. Shit. You serious?
Yeah, man's
fuck
insane.
That guy.
Yeah.
It wasn't because of me, was it?
No. We have our own problems. I should have been more careful.
No. Not at all. If anything, I should have thought about what happened with you guys.
Yeah, I didn't even think about
involved.
It.
That's crazy.
The whole thing makes me want to just... I swear, if I ever meet that shithead, I'm gonna...
What? What are you gonna do when you meet Damon Merrick?
Something terrible.
Uh-huh.
No way!
I am.
Like...
Karate.
Challenge him to a karaoke battle?
Oh, karaoke.
Yeah, that's how we settle things on the street, huh?
Okay.
Throw dice at him.
Criticize his taste in film.
Okay,
Tell him about a band he's probably never heard of, but should have.
Enough.
Damn. Too far.
Anyway, we're glad Rachel's okay. You should hang out here till she wakes up.
Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready. What are you guys doing?
I thought you'd never ask. I had to hide our game from the nurse. She thinks it's negatively affecting my mood.
Elamond's backed himself into a pretty tight spot this time. He might not make it.
Wait a sec. Barb the Elf Barbarian. She can join Elamond.
I kinda have to. I'm sorry. We're gonna do a quick detour.
Could actually make it out alive.
Wait. You're into this nerd shit too?
Totally.
It's a game where I win if I make up crazy shit and act like a badass.
So, yes. I hate to be such a game master about it, but I'm pretty sure Chloe's character died last time.
Oh, yeah.
Becoming another one.
Wait a sec. Didn't you have that anklet of reincarnation in your inventory?
Yeah. I totally did have that thing.
Holy shit. So you can actually swoop in and save my ass.
What do you say?
You bet.
Gotta save Elamond, right?
Kinda have to.
We rejoin Elamond as he majestically soars over the Traveler's Path. He glances over his shoulder, only to discover his pursuers are right behind him.
Wait, you can fly?
I'm a wizard. Plus, I kinda have to since you cut my feet off last time.
So funny.
Oh, yeah. I totally did that.
You totally did.
This game is awesome.
Elamond comes around a corner to discover Barb, the elf barbarian, sitting by a fire, roasting squirrels.
Barb! Greetings.
Greetings, powerful Elamond. From whence do you run? Float. Or whatever.
Funny you should ask. I'm being chased by an army of dragonkin.
Remember when you killed that jailer and took his key to free the prisoners in the prison camp? Turns out you offended their entire clan.
Oh no!
You're after me now.
Need a hand?
Sounds like you could use a hand from your favorite elf barbarian.
Well,
let's go.
You did manage to inflict an insane amount of damage on everything.
Suddenly, dragonkin scouts rush in, clawing you while your backs are turned. Take 4 damage. You're up first. What do you want to do?
Disarm, bare hand, spinning slash. Go with the spin!
I do a spinning slash.
16.
Good enough. You spin around, using your axe to slash all 6 dragonkin at once. They all
We're
drop
powerful.
Down in a puddle of blood.
Hey, nice one.
Don't celebrate yet. You begin to hear the clinking armor of hundreds of dragonkin warriors. The sound grows louder as they grow closer.
And this is why I was running.
Running sounds good.
Running and living. Yeah, sounds like a plan.
You sprint as fast as you can until you come across a fork in the road. One path leads into the mouth of a deep, dark cave. The other takes you into a dense, misty forest. Which way do you go?
Forest!
All right. To the forest it is.
Let's go.
As soon as you enter the shade of the great trees, it becomes eerily silent. and very cold. You notice the stones on the ground are arranged in strange patterns, creating huge designs all over the forest floor.
I think I know what this is. I follow the stones.
The stones lead you to the center of the forest, where you see a mysterious glowing idol upon a golden pedestal.
A forest idol? I could use that to regrow my feet. Help me steal it.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Now this is my kind of skill challenge.
Awesome. Roll for idol theft.
8.
As you approach the idol, you dash your foot against one of the stones and fall face first into the dirt. A bony Yikes. Hand shoots up from the ground right before your eyes. You feel the ground move and jump up just in time for the undead soldier buried there to sit up from
No!
his shallow grave. Dirt and pebbles cascade down his fleshless torso. Then, the ground beneath you shakes. Bony, rotting hands shoot up from the ground all around as an entire army of undead warriors rises from their graves.
Yikes.
You have disrupted the undead forest, an ancient burial ground for fallen soldiers. They surround you now, armed to the teeth, bony faces grinning.
Run.
Luckily, the undead have a very low running speed. The party flees safely, but the soldiers aren't far behind. You're near the edge of the forest when you run across...
Oh, shit. Is that me?
Let's
go! You
gonna
play?
Yeah, little brother.
Pavel, the arrogant gnome bard, joins your party.
Yay!
Gnome bard.
That's what she said.
Know any firewalk?
No, I don't know any of your shitty music.
Damn.
That's some big talk from someone who's only 3 feet tall.
Size isn't everything.
This is awesome.
It's fine. He's
fine,
making a penis joke!
Don't slow us down.
In the time you've been chatting, the army of undead has caught up to you. The first cohort launches iron spears directly at Elamon. What do you do?
Shield him with my body. Shield him with the bar.
I grab the bard and use him to shield Elamon.
Whoa, hey. Can she do that?
All's fair in love and tabletop.
Let's go.
You whip the bard's little body back and forth, catching every spear as they fly at you. The gnome shrieks, perfect F sharp with every impact.
That was sick.
Oh my god. You're a monster.
You burst forth into the majestic meadow, horizon to horizon. All you can see is lush green fields full of birds, flowers, and dragonkin.
God what? Damn it!
Instead of chasing you, they circle around to set a trap. And you just walked right into it. As the dragonkin ahead prepare to attack, the army of undead arrive behind you.
No!
We're surrounded and screwed.
Come on, Elamon. I'm sure you've got some sweet spell that'll save us.
I do have Searing Crystal.
Perfect! Searing Crystal, these fuckers!
Sure.
You don't get it. This isn't just another battle spell. This crystal is like dropping a nuke. It'll kill everything, including you and me.
Actually, you did grab Durgeron's bracer of fire immunity. Whoever wears it would survive.
What is he doing? See? Oh, he's on his phone! But he's just... Why?
There's only one bracer.
What the fuck was that? Sacrifice me!
Mikey loves his character. I can't just let him get Elamon killed.
To succeed in backtalk, you must listen to your opponent and choose related comeback. Okay.
Elamon, keep the bracer and cast the spell.
What is going on right there? God damn it.
It won't work. Look at all of them. I should have never started this quest. I'm too weak.
Stronger than
Elamon. You beat the shit out of Durgaron and took his bracelet.
Bracer.
Yeah. Bracer. That. See, you can do anything.
But I've never even used this spell before. What if I roll too low?
Never back down. You've never died. I believe in you. Never back down.
You know what else you've never done?
Oh.
Given up.
I didn't read
it
right.
Either of us is going to survive. This is the only way.
You're the only friend who's ever helped me. I can't leave you behind.
You can help if I am. I can be replaced. You can help everyone.
You're, like, the most heroic person I know. You help everyone. It's my turn to save you from something.
Period. No.
No, Barb. I won't just kill you.
Kill them too. Can't kill yourself. Don't be afraid. Kill them too!
You kill all of these monsters too. Think of how many lives you'll be saving by nuking their stupid faces off.
Alright.
Yes!
I'm so sorry, Chloe.
It is okay. I believe in you.
Elamon secures the bracer of fire immunity on his wrist. He gives the elf barbarian one last nod and reaches to the sky.
Let's go!
The searing crystal lifts from his hands, floating up into the clouds.
Okay, now he's back in.
Suddenly, an explosion. Fire arcs outward in a ring. Then the ring begins to spin.
Whoa.
A quiet stillness encompasses the meadow as all creatures gaze upward at the swirling flames.
Thank you, Chloe, for everything.
It's been an honor, Elma.
The flames descend over the meadow, bathing everything in liquefying arcs of infernal chaos. Monsters begin screaming in agony.
Badass.
Chloe, you've got one final moment before your angry elven body is burned away forever. Any last words?
No words, but I do flip all the monsters the double bird.
Let's go.
Keep the moment going.
Woo!
The spell comes to a spectacular climax until all you can see is white. Then, all is calm. All is quiet. All is ash.
Damn.
Congratulations, Elamon. You have completed Revenge of the Dragonkin.
Let's go.
That's it? She's dead? And the game's over?
Yep. And Elamon's left alone once again. It was fun having a companion while it lasted.
Well, I gotta just make another character.
What if I make a new character?
Wait. Really? You wanna keep playing?
Sure.
No!
This is gonna be dope.
Brother. Brotherly love.
That was a pretty intense one.
That was cute.
Yeah.
Thanks for playing. It always means a lot to Mikey.
Yeah.
Seems like the least I could do.
True. Alright. Let's go talk to... Can I graffiti?
Mikey's nurses must love this.
Wait, what? What did he say?
Mikey's nurses must love this.
Cause of admission, medication, healing potions. That's funny.
Hey. Wait up a sec. Sorry I got angry at you yesterday. About the money.
No, you have the right to be angry. I'm holding myself. It's okay.
Don't worry about it. You were in a really tough situation.
A situation I created. When you said that Damon stabbed Rachel, I kept thinking, I'm supposed to look out for Mikey, not bring this shit into his life.
Mm-hmm.
I think you saved us from something so much worse.
I'm glad. That makes
Thank you.
I still felt bad about that decision.
Sure.
Thanks for stopping by.
Bye, Chloe.
Let's go. It's been an honor. Rachel, wait. So she'd love to see you. Thanks. I got it.
Hey. Just heard the fire went out.
Went out? You mean it's controlled?
No. It's completely out. It extinguished itself.
How could that
Those
be?
Those guys look exhausted.
The fire's out.
Unless you get stabbed.
Everything.
Down. Damn it, I can't graffiti.
Huh?
Damn it! That I could graffiti. Oh shit.
Why has my son been assigned to you? I never authorized that he be seen by. I was assigned because Nathan was becoming quite upset. So they sent a psychiatrist. Because my son was upset.
Holy shit.
Please, Mr. Prescott, your son needs serious psychiatric. My son needs nothing from you. He put down a couple of bullies who were harassing him at school.
What do you do?
I'm so relieved that Rachel's awake. I should see her right away.
Sorry, I was eavesdropping.
Hey. Chloe, I can't even express thank you so much. I'm sorry. I'm a wreck. I stepped out to get some air. Rachel doesn't need me crying in front of her. Your hair. I almost didn't notice it.
Oh. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
I bet Rachel loves it. I can't imagine what I would do if we lost her.
It's going to be fine.
I'm sure everything's going to be fine.
That's what James keeps saying. He's so strong in a crisis, you know?
My dad was like that.
That hurts her.
I'm sure he was. Just like his daughter.
Aww! Thank you.
I just keep feeling like we were lucky. It could have gone so much worse, you know?
I'm sure it would have been if you weren't there for her. I am so glad you and Rachel have found each other. When you meet someone who changes everything, you just know.
Well, hang in there, Mrs. Amber.
I will.
Let's go. Let's go. Dude. What the fuck?
Dad. I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
It really hurts.
Shh. The pain will pass.
Oh.
Chloe's here. You want me to stay?
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
Damn.
I'll come back in a little while.
My guardian angel. How are you? Not great. Better with you here.
No.
Rachel, I'm sorry. What for? You're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard.
What? Shut up.
You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. I'm so sorry.
And you saved my life. You saved my life.
Don't do that again.
Just don't do that again.
Play the damsel in distress. You got it.
No. Attack a psycho with a 2x4. That was crazy.
Newsflash, Chloe. I'm a little crazy.
Period.
Crazy hot.
Nice. Nice flirting. Totally the
Happy
time.
Your dad's here.
I mean, I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe.
Like on Mount Hood.
Would you do something for me?
Anything.
Sarah. My mom.
Uh-oh.
So weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her.
Are you sure?
Are you sure? She could be completely different than you imagine.
I'm sure.
Okay.
I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay. But if she is, will you find her, please?
You really want this, don't you?
I do, Chloe. I really do.
Okay. Fuck.
Then, of course, whatever it takes.
I bet my dad has her number. Maybe in his office. Our house key's just under the mat. The code is 0722.
I...
To your dad's office? 0722.
Yeah. My birthday.
No.
I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are.
Oh.
Thank you, Chloe. For everything.
You got it, Rachel. Sorry, I keep yawning. I'm not tired. Because I'm like bored of the game. I had a long day at school today. So I apologize for being rude.
Hey, Elliot.
Oh.
Hey!
I keep confusing him.
Wait. Your hair, it's different.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like it. It's nice. I like your shirt, too. You never told me you were into cars.
Guess you don't know everything about me.
nice balloon.
Nice balloon, I guess.
Yeah, it's from Mikey. Were you just in there?
I'm actually here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here? What happened?
She's keeping it private.
I think she's keeping that private for now.
Ugh, I'm back. Sorry.
She's okay, though.
Well, that's good.
Nice balloon.
I guess I'll stop by after I see Mikey.
She probably wants privacy.
Oh. Right, of course. Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
Nothing we can't handle?
Nothing we can't handle.
Chloe. I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately, right?
So what?
Yeah,
so, obviously, something is going on.
It's really okay.
I swear, man. Everything's really okay.
Take my word for it, asshole. Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I thought, bitch.
I trust you. Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks.
I won't.
Anyway. See you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
No. All right, Frank, what the fuck? Bruh? Why was Damon there? Why did you bring him along? God damn it. Oh, I zoned out. I forgot that we were just going back to the house.
Hello?
It's a beautiful door. A little unsafe, but it's beautiful. My back's kind of killing me. You're not gonna close the front door? What is wrong with you? Bruh,
I need to.
Oh, come on! I wanted to close the front door, you weirdo! No. Don't break it. Don't break it. God damn.
It's the big one.
God damn.
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
Ooh. Graffiti. Let's go. Funny.
Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
James, this is enough. When you told me in the park that you weren't going to let me be part of Rachel's life, of course I was angry, but I understood and needed to protect her. It's your prerogative as a parent. But sending that man to talk sense into me, threaten me, you're losing your moral high ground here. What kind of way is that for DA to act? What would the voters say? I have the right to meet my daughter. The lawyer I spoke to agrees, but more importantly, Rachel has the right to know who her mother is. Tell her the truth. You know it's right. What happened? Like, what did he do?
James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Why do I keep pressing the wrong button? Yeah.
I'm not gonna be able to smash my way through this one. Hopefully, there's a key around somewhere.
I'll find it.
Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
I haven't. Who's that?
Best dad. That stuff is all politics anyway.
I knew it! Key! I knew it.
Found you.
Brother never cleaned up after herself. Sorry, it was just a thing. I'm in a rush here.
Welcome to Shadyville.
Sounded like it was just a phone. Oh, sorry.
I have to know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
It's with Damon. That's why he was there. I told you you can help me with my problem. Crossing the line, eh? Let's talk. We'll call the night. I found who you were looking for. Call you 15. Well, this isn't charity. I'm gonna need you to do what we talked about. I can't. Sure, because I talked to a girl. She has a big mouth. Turns out she's not so easy. We're going to need to be more hands-on. Don't hurt her. Relax. I got my best guy on it. How's your daughter? You know she attacked me first, right? It is Damon. You should teach her to behave better. Nothing? Guess he needed to soon take care of her anyway. No, wait. He didn't initiate it, but he's been talking to Damon.
James is working with Damon Merrick? This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah?
No, it sounded like...
Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sarah is. But how do I get him to tell me?
You'll pay... Where's he? You're zooming now? Relax, man. It's simple. Either you want or you do what I want, or your little problem becomes a big problem. Now, do you take care of the evidence or not?
Shit. What do I say?
You first. I know you're new at this, but I'll give you a pass. Don't fuck with me. Let's see the proof of the evidence.
Hope James actually has this evidence.
Don't think Damon will tell me where Sarah is. Unless I send him a picture.
This.
James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Yeah, it has to be one of these.
Sheldon.
Sorry.
Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Which file? Like, do you
James
want me to take a picture
of
the file?
On Frank? I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
Evidence box.
This must be what Damon was talking about.
This looks like someone got hurt.
Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just... If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
Number Ellie.
Could this be the evidence? Damon and Knives seem like a solid bet.
Victim Ellie.
Did Damon really shoot someone? Guess I shouldn't be surprised.
I'm not surprised. Probably gloves, right? I mean, which one are we supposed to know?
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
Assault. Aggravated assault with deadly weapon. Demon Maverick. Thomas Lover, this is it. Bro. After a verbal altercation with the victim, Maverick brandished a fire poker, hitting the victim several times in the head before fleeing the scene. Maverick's gloves were recovered and turned into evidence. A 911 call was received at 10:21 p.m. and an officer arrived at the scene at 10:38 p.m. with EMT. The victim was taken to a hospital. Bystander was requested to remain anonymous, named David Maverick, as the assailant.
Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Okay. I gotta figure out how to do this. I feel bad though, because someone was hurt and I'm just destroying evidence. Cool. Don't feel great about it.
Better not touch that again.
Nice. So, since you're showing evidence, might as well tell me which of the guys is the snitch. I don't know. No more. God damn it.
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching.
Mm-hmm. let's look through these files.
Okay. There's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charge.
Yeah, Frank doesn't seem like too bad of a guy.
This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment.
Damn. Alright. So we get this.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy.
Sorry, my stomach just growled, sorry to hear it. I did defend it as follows: guilty of stolen goods. No, that doesn't seem like snitch. It might be.
Oh, man, this guy's the snitch. He was so cool to me at the mill. Wonder if there's someone else I could pin it on instead.
Yeah, let's pin it on this asshole. Right here.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases.
This one.
This is that freak from the mill.
Sheldon.
Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment. Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right.
Well, I know who it is. I'm just gonna do it on someone else. Frank, no. Sheldon, right? Parole officer. Can't take care of that fucker. Oh god, he's gonna kill him. Alright, well. I kinda suspect he was gonna kill him. That's why I wanted to do that asshole, even though murder is never okay.
Payment? Fuck.
Fuck.
Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be? I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Sorry, my mom's texting me. Okay. Damn.
Holy shit.
That's a big stack of cash.
Fuck, that's Sarah. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her?
Finish the job? Are you gonna kill her? Cold feet, you're really new at this. How about I leave her box?
Holy shit.
Oh god.
Does James even know what he's doing? Okay. I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
Elliot?
Hey.
What the
Elliot?
Fuck?
You
followed me?
What are you doing here?
Stalker much? Right?
Did he really just follow me here?
Elliot, what the fuck?
Did you follow me from the hospital?
I did. I'm worried about you.
Jesus, I told you I was fine.
You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe, what is...
Elliot, put that down. You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, God, what have you gotten yourself into?
Why do you care?
You wouldn't understand.
Back off!
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
None of your business.
Honestly, Elliot, you can judge me all you want, but it's pretty fucked up that you're here right now, and I don't have time for this.
When?
What?
When will you have time? For me? You have all the time in the world for Rachel.
It's not about you.
You're not seeing who Rachel really is. When will you realize what she's doing to you?
It's not about you.
Just take a step back.
You're a real horrible piece of fucking work.
You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
She saved me.
You don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
Literally.
Stop suggesting that she's somehow bad.
The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble.
Because she never got in trouble before. It was my choice.
I took the fall because I wanted to. Rachel tried to protect me.
Yet somehow, it all worked out for her in the end.
Because she's never gotten in trouble before. I have.
You don't understand. You weren't there.
I fucking hate him.
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in? She let you make a fool out of yourself.
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before...
I've been quiet long enough. Look, Rachel is an amazing actress. And I don't mean on stage. She's fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
I think you're just upset that I'm hanging out with someone else.
I promise.
I really think you're just jealous.
No one is manipulating me.
No? Just look where you are now. A high school dropout. Hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy.
You followed me.
It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened.
Stalker much?
Dude, you know you sound a little stalkerish right now.
Stalking is defined as repeated unwanted interactions. How long have my interactions been unwanted?
Why do you know the definition of stalker? That's
Elliot.
Worse.
I'm the one who cares about you,
that's
Chloe.
That's worse.
Me, not Rachel. It's time you saw the truth.
Bro.
What does that mean?
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
Oh my god, you literally are a stalker. No, I'm not.
Look, I'm sorry, but I really need to go.
Stab him with the pen. I will get. What the
fuck?
Why
did you make me do that?
What?
Can't you just listen to me?
Oh my god. Okay, he's gonna like hurt us.
Elliot's gone full blown crazy. I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me.
Wow. My hero.
We have a lot.
Everything's
about
you, isn't it?
And I don't
care
how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
Bash him over the head with that lamp.
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad?
That's smart.
Let's talk.
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
Wow.
Here's what's going on. We're at the DA's house, and we should probably leave before he comes back.
Don't worry. With Rachel in the hospital, James isn't coming anytime soon. I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
Life is at risk. You're keeping me here.
You're the one who's keeping me here. At the Arcadia Bay DA James Amber's house.
Bro, what the fuck? What just happened? Why did I do that?
You're acting strange. What's going on?
What? Nothing.
How did I fail by pressing something? What?
Ugh, you bitch! Can't you see? I just want to help you.
Did you ever ask for what I wanted?
You're going to assault me now? That's how far you'll go to protect Rachel?
You are the one who's the problem.
No, you idiot.
What the fuck?
Better run, dickbag. Cops will be here any minute.
I am so glad I friend-zoned that asshole. I am so happy. Oh my god, he's a stalker. Well, fuck him. I regret nothing now. I feel no sympathy for you. We're on time for this.
So much destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad.
Don't.
He's been lying to her all her life. And he's still lying.
I was about to say, like, are you about to like agree with Elliot?
Being a dad's tough.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
True.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I suppose everyone lies
about big things. I mean, the stuff Mom doesn't know about me. So you probably lied too.
Would you love me less?
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
Yeah.
Ready as I'll ever be.
Problem is, I'm dead. So how am I supposed to tell you anything?
Wow. That's brutal.
wish you'd told me when you could have.
You don't like the perfect relationship we had?
I wish you'd lived long enough for us to fuck it up. No word. My ride, my tunes. Am I seriously going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel? Am I crazy?
Hella crazy.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company.
Besides, let's go.
You don't want to miss this.
Yes.
Things are about to get real.
Dangerous, but cool. Let's go! Fuck Elliot, man. I'm still mad. Come for a circle while we're back here.
Shit. Is that blood?
Is Frank okay? Is his dog okay? I swear to God.
Frank? Frank!
Preston.
Shit, this is bad. I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom.
Thank God he did get her. But he's not dead, because he's in the prequel. Wow, it really did come full circle. We're back here.
Where the hell is Sarah? No more beer. No more time. I've got to keep moving.
It's good just in case, because he's a violent person.
Frank's couch is toast.
Oh no, poor Frank. I'm assuming we can't go upstairs. Yep. All right.
Don't tell me what to do. I'm not afraid.
Can I take the bomb with me? I like the lost steam connection.
No.
Shh. Everything's going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
I just want to meet my daughter. Can't you understand? Why does
he- Your daughter? G,
Jesus. So that's what he's worried about. Can't let the public know. The mother of his daughter is some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to...
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture. So that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
This is...
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
Got an intervene.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
Can we just talk about what's going on here?
Okay. What should we talk about?
Whatever James told you, Sarah doesn't deserve this. She didn't do anything wrong.
You think I give a shit about what she did? My job is to make problems go away, and she's the
Look, I just think...
No!
Talking's over.
Leave her alone!
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Get away from her.
I said shut the fuck up.
Damn. No.
Go to your fucking happy place.
Oh, man.
Run.
Let this be a lesson. Kid, make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon! What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again. Do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again.
God, he got scared.
Fuck you.
Oh, God, the fucking head.
Sarah. Rachel. Your daughter. She...
I know Frank doesn't die, so he can't. He's in the next game.
Sarah? Chloe Price.
Yeah, my name.
You know who I am.
I'm asleep.
I saw you in the play. You were funny. Thanks. Sit.
Huh?
Sarah, are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry for...
Rachel can never know.
What exactly can't Rachel know?
What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with...
He's a piece of shit. And I promise that...
Rachel can never know.
I don't understand.
Tell me why.
Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar.
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever.
Don't you think the truth matters more?
The truth? What's so great about the truth, Chloe?
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken, Sarah.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away?
You're here now. That's what matters.
What do you know?
I know Rachel needs you. I know loss. I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it.
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear gone. No more sadness, no more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
I don't know anything about addiction, but I know what it's like to be needed by someone. It gives you strength you never knew you had. Rachel needs you.
Rachel needs her family.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing
Rachel is. So this isn't a dream, is it? This is real.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant. And talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole, and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't
it's
deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you?
Oh, shit.
You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
Don't you want to see her?
Don't you want to see her? You came here for it. You got sober. You deserve the chance to know your daughter.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her, protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt.
Fuck. It's a lot. So a lot please, to put on me.
Tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Damn.
Wait. I'll take care of her, you know.
I believe you. Goodbye, Chloe.
I don't know. I don't know what the right decision was. I don't think there's a right choice here. It's all fucked. My apologies. Yeah. I won't say shit.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
I'm gonna lie to her, guys. I'm sorry.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a 6 scar.
Let's go!
Maybe a tat is in order. To go with the one you gave me.
Fuck yeah.
We never actually escaped. Did we?
We've got time.
All the time in the world. So, how did everything go?
I'm gonna lie.
Rachel, I've gotta tell you something.
I'm sorry, baby girl.
Hey. What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny, you seemed so confident. I really thought you'd find her.
Sorry.
Yeah. Me too. Maybe we can try tomorrow.
Maybe she hasn't left town yet. Of course. I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much. How do you know that?
Yikes, Chloe.
Because why should she be any different from the rest of us?
Okay. I see. I'm so sorry. I don't know. That's such a rough decision. That's a huge ass knife. Puppy! Look at him. Aw. Oh shit. Oh shit. Aw. Right into the kitchen, huh? Oh. She smiled a little bit at the end. Yeah, fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. I don't feel bad. I don't feel bad for shit. Oh, they got the brother to play. No! I wouldn't allow it. I don't feel bad for anything. You can't make me. What? Victoria's just had a thing for her? The baby! Fun little prequel. Oh, it's still going. Full blue. I'm ready for it. Woo! That's the Chloe I know.
Shake your head, have some fun.
yeah, that's Chloe. I mean, Rachel. Friends before everything happened within the first game, which I do like more. But this was a fun little, just to see a little glance into what's going on. I thought it was gonna be more closer to when Rachel disappeared, though. I didn't know it was gonna be like when they met. I'm okay with that. That was fun. I definitely like Life is Strange more, but this one wasn't bad. It was just a fun ride. It was definitely always gonna be different, you know? I'm gonna let the credits play. I definitely love just seeing Rachel in general. It's nice to like see the person that we worked so hard to find in the first game. You know? Like, because we worked so hard to find her. But all I got in terms of relationship wise was who. We just saw it through the eyes of Chloe in the first game. So it's nice to like actually see. Max is in this? I never heard. There's two Chloe Prices, really? I didn't know that. Sorry I yawned a lot of this dude this playthrough. I'm doing it again! I'm not yawning because I'm tired. I'm yawning because I had a long day at school. Not the game. I almost didn't stream because I was really tired, but I was like, I gotta get this over with because next week was the last one of this, but this is definitely the end of the Rachel and Chloe, like, part. Because next is the Chloe and Max, which is we're gonna do next week. And next week is my week before spring break, which I am taking off. Hope you guys don't mind. college has been kind of rough. Kind of kicking my ass, and I felt really, been feeling really just drained lately. But I want to do my best to work hard on this channel and for Twitch and for YouTube at the same time. Cause I would love it if I can do it for a living. So I'm gonna work at it. So I've been grinding well enough to where it's still fun for me. It doesn't feel like it's a grind yet, or it doesn't feel like it's a chore. Cause I still do it for fun, while also hoping, you know. So it's. I'm doing I'm doing my best to balance, but I definitely think I think I need a break after next week. Especially since I have midterms coming up. And I love streaming. I'm trying to find a balance. I think I did find a balance. Social school just is still tiring me. So I do my best to not be tired during streams, but today got the better of me. Told Rachel the truth. You didn't. Nice. Good to know. I'm not crazy. You killed the plant with soda. No! No! It died. You accepted the photograph. Yeah. You didn't have Drew's money at the start of the day. What? I could take it? You visited North at the hospital. Yes, I did. You didn't donate to the fire fund. Didn't know that was a thing. You convinced Damon that, yes. Rachel didn't mean her mother. Rachel, but there was a chance that she could be her mom? Interesting.
To me, sir. Why did you have to do that? I could have been fine if you didn't do this.
I could have been fine. That's so fucked up. I hate you for this. You're fucking naked. You didn't have to do that to me. That's evil. You didn't have to. That's evil. I hated that. I thought we were gonna make it without having to see that. That's stupid, and I didn't like that. Alright. Well, I think that's gonna be it for today. So, I liked it. It was fun. Hope you guys enjoyed today. I will have this video out by Friday. And to next week, we'll be doing the last bonus episode, but this is the completion of the Chloe and Rachel story. And that is okay. It was nice, it was short and sweet. It wasn't like the first game, and it didn't have to be. It didn't need to be, it was different. It wasn't the same. I definitely like the first game a little more, but that's okay. This wasn't bad. It was nice just to see the characters. It was nice to meet Rachel. It was nice to see just Chloe again. I loved Chloe so much. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed watching. And I'll see you guys next week for the bonus episode. And then after that, I will be taking a break. So I hope you won't miss me too much. I'm kidding. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy. And I'll see you later.